Hello, and welcome.
Thank you.
To this report.
Yes, we are changing things up.
Because really, who wants to sit through the same match again?
We are trying to. We are men of the people, and we have heard your requests for us to just fucking get to Money in the Bank. So that's what we're gonna do. So we're gonna give you the results for these shows, and then we're gonna do Money in the Bank. And then after that, we're going to figure out what we're going to do, because I'm really sick of seeing the same fucking matches every goddamn week. So, and I'm sure you are too. We're trying our best. There's only, let's be fair here, we tried our best to make you guys give a shit. So hopefully we get brownie points for that.
How many rubber matches can we have it?
So yeah, really.
Daniel Bryan doesn't even like protection.
So, let us move to some results.
And on
the go home raw. Yeah.
This is what dual booked Fit Finley and William Stephen Regal. That's and Regal good. Won. I'm so shocked. And then the U.S. champion in Slaughter at a table match.
What the fuck? Why is this happening on a. Can we watch this?
No. Why? We gotta keep going, Johnny. We gotta be mad.
I wanna see it.
I wanna see that.
We can book it ourselves on the next show.
Okay, fair enough.
And then Sting wins. Next, Santino.
What the Sandow. Fuck? Rivalry match?
Punk probably interferes.
Oh. Why does it do this on the fucking one that we don't watch?
All that hype. And Sandow wins because of Punk, but the title is not on the line because we didn't watch it.
Right.
Oh, okay, good.
Jesus. Ah,
this match again. Fuck this match. And then, of course, Batista and Hogan one more time.
Of course.
And Batista
gets the win going into the pay-per-view.
All right, what a show. Let's that table match.
What a great show. Let's get some news.
Wow, I'm shocked.
Spoiler, so CM Punk did attack Santino during that
I'm
match.
I'm shocked at all these happenings.
Of course, the one fucking week that we decided not to watch this shit. House show.
All right, Finley and oh, no more Christian Kali. What a shame. Finley and Kali battled, and Finley won. And then poor Intercontinental Champion taking on a cunt. And he wins. Oh, Brie Mode and Paige. And then a girl won. And the big dog against the big dog. And the big dog wins. And then the big dog came back younger and fought DDP. And he won again. Oh, gotta sell that show at Money the Bank. And Lesnar wins.
Oh,
my.
Filthy animals and Sting.
What could happen here?
Of course.
Sting goes over.
Of course he did.
Kali and fucking
cross your arms.
Cross your arms even more, Naomi. Oh, God. Hot Rick Rude comes back to take on Iron Mustafa. Mustafa wins. The big dog. And the big dog wins, and then he comes back younger to face DDP, and he wins again. And then this
I got pushed up the card.
Semi-main event.
Of the house show, of course. That must have been a great match on Raw.
And then the main event was Kali versus Sting.
Oh, shit.
And Sting retains the U.S. title.
What should have happened?
Okay, Adnan and Bigelow. Bigelow wins. And then the arms continue. It's an arms race. And Luger wins. And then Finley and Slaughter go at each other like animals. And Slaughter wins. And then Roman Reigns takes on The Undertaker. And the big dog wins again. And then he comes back younger to face DDP. And wins it. Oh!
Oh!
Change things up. And then I gotta sell that pay-per-view. Brock Lesnar and Corey Graves.
The champ wins.
Brock Lesnar wins. And then Triple H and Batista. And Batista wins heading into his title match. And then on the go show to SmackDown, we actually start without a tag team match. It's Paige and Brie Bella. And Brie Bella can beats. Fuck. Falls count anywhere. Bad news Baron and the cunt. Bad news wins. Oh, I'm shocked at this one. JBL wins. Oh, gotta sell that pay-per-view. And Lester wins. They're 2-2.
2-2.
Best of 5 series. And this one again. Jesus Christ.
This is all one. All
right.
All right.
Moving on.
There we go.
Including the first match, which will be Money in the Bank. Oh, no.
Saturday Night's Main Event. Excuse you.
I'm sorry.
Cross your arms.
And hope to die. And then the big dog faces the big dog. And then these two mustached men fight, and something happens. And then the big dog fights the big dog, and then he gets younger and faces Teeny and wins.
What's next, huh?
And then, oh fuck!
Brock and Corey Graves again.
Brock, Corey Graves.
Oh, oh shit! Okay. Of course.
And then Sting fights somebody.
Again.
For the United States title. And Sting retains.
Alright, so we got some news. Fandango delivered retribution to JBL, earning the support of the WWE Universe. What?
Didn't he lose?
No, he won. I think he... Oh yeah, he did lose. What the fuck?
He probably attacked him from
behind. Who knows what happened?
Alright, and now we're going to find out who won 60%.
It's time for Money in the Bank.
Money.
Oh, God damn it!
Oh, shit. Wait, it's the main event in this one. Okay, they did change things up. Look at all these matches.
Do you want to run down the card, or should we just go into it?
Oh, let's run down the card. All right. I think you know what it is.
Run down that card, Jericho.
We got a submission match between JBL and Fandango. We go full circle here with the first match. False count anywhere for the NXT title, Santino and CM Punk. And then one-on-one in the middle of the fucking card, Brock Lesnar and Corey Graves. Naturally, we're going to skip the fuck out of this. It's not even a title on the line.
I know, what the fuck? Oh yeah, that's right, neither of them are champs.
Like, fuck off that match. And then
why is the belt not on the line?
The title's not on the line.
The fuck?
We're gonna make it on the line.
We are.
This match, too, and then in the Money in the Bank ladder match. We have Triple H, Seth Rollins. Jesus Christ.
That's a fucking awesome match, actually.
We're going to keep that exactly.
Yeah, that is staying that way.
The yellow champion is also in this match.
Oh, shit. I think we're going to keep that one.
Oh, yeah.
All right, so I guess we should get this show on the road.
Let's make this fast, please.
This one? Okay. Oh, yeah, it's submission.
Submission match.
Okay. Let's do this!
Oh, God.
Money in the Bank, boys.
Shorty's what you think.
This match representing SmackDown. Opening Money in the Bank.
I don't know who's on what show in the main event.
We'll figure it out when we get there.
These two have been going at it, but why? Could we see the reveal of Fandango's true master?
We're in Washington, Michael.
Is it Obama?
Look at that big fucking ladder.
Oh, he's got a different entrance because it's a fucking flat stage.
Will he dance?
He just took off his hat.
Will he show his dancing moves?
Yes, ma'am. Yeah, I'm JBL. Money falls.
The rain moggle.
He didn't want to run over ladders.
That's nice of him.
He's happy because he's really had Fandango's number this entire time. He's 4-0.
I've been informed
him.
That Fandango stole JBL's limo on the last episode of SmackDown.
Was JBL's limo his master?
No, it's just the horns on the front of it.
Ah.
No. Who knows who his master is?
Narrow.
A submission match will be the end of this feud.
Hey, fuck you.
Vintage Hatile style.
I'm JBL! Woo!
A wrestling good god.
What is you good for?
Money. It's time to dance.
You think he's finally used to his upgrades?
Can you make a robot submit? Did Santino make him submit? I don't remember.
Oh, JBL made him submit 4 weeks ago.
Did he?
Yes, that's their first match.
Oh, there you go. Full circle. That's what you were talking about. Here it comes.
I'd like to go full circle on that robot.
But Jesus Christ, Jericho.
The big dog don't play.
There he is. An intimidating dancing man. The dirtiest dancer in the game. The dancing machine, Fandango.
The new and improved Fandango.
What would you do if you had a man like that in your home?
I'd make him vacuum.
Why?
Because I don't want to.
All right, that's fine.
That's fair enough.
Duel, are you excited for this match? How do you feel about the competition, especially Fandango?
I am indifferent, but I do enjoy the submission match idea. I wish I thought of it.
Of course you did. You came up with a tables match. I've never seen a match like that before.
How does that match work, Duel?
The first one to properly set the table wins.
Oh, wow.
Well, no man knows how to set a table.
The WWE Universe hates Fandango, hates JBL so much that they're cheering a cyborg that's trying to destroy the company.
Yeah, I am.
That doesn't sound like him.
That's my new voice.
No, it's Jericho, stop horsing around over there.
I'm sorry, I'm silly. Excited. So this silly. New and improved Fandango, he has all the tools to be one of the best, but he's just not used to his own power. He's all greased up, so JBL will have a hard time.
It's oil!
That intimidating mask.
That is a scary fucking mask. It's screwed into his head.
That's fucking gross.
It's horrifying.
There's his master. But who is it?
Who is that
depicting? Kinda got JBL's hair, to be honest.
Oh. I think you have an agenda you're pushing here.
No.
And here we go, kicking off Money in the Bank with this heated rivalry. Killed Fandango with that one. Uh-oh.
Can you kill that which does not live?
Oh, can you elbow a robot in the heart? Do robots have hearts? Ha.
Do tent men have hearts?
Hatile, do they?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Oh, he was muted.
He's booking the rest of the show. Oh, no, we already know what the card is. Disregard. Flapjacks!
I love a maggot.
That is a wrinkly apron.
Will Fandango finally beat JBL? You know, story slime would assume so.
Story slime.
Story
slime.
Ah, and then he'll make out with Summer Rae, and this master will come down from the ceiling.
Ejaculating.
And it'll be Bray Wyatt's rocking chair.
Oh, God. Punching away at the domeski of JBL.
Remember, the only way to win this match is to make your opponent submit.
Does a robot really feel pain, though? I mean, it looks like he's in a bit of pain.
Maybe a bit. He's a dancing machine.
Oh, backbreaker. That same backbreaker is what helped Brock Lesnar beat Corey Graves at one point.
Yeah, we've still got that exciting match to come.
Yes. Fandango pulls JBL right in. A big backdrop. Everything he does is big, 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 no matter what.
The big dog appreciates that.
Into the corner again. Both these men struggling to keep the advantage here as Fandango pops out of that. Into the corner again. Why are they throwing each other into the corner over and over again?
They're trying to break each other's backs.
Oh, God. Oh, his eyes. Do robots have eyes?
Are our eyes real?
RR.
Are our eyes real?
Camel clutch. He's pulling on the fake skin. The referee's not even looking.
He's trying to rip that head right off of that bolted neck.
How can the referee see if he taps out? Whoa. Oh. Bullying him. You can't soap a robot's ass because it'll malfunction.
You'll electrocute yourself.
Yeah. Uh-oh. JBL may be going for that clothesline from hell. Oh, Fandango punching him away, though. Big Slupex.
Slupex slitty slit.
Look at those chiseled abs.
On JBL?
Of course. Oh, where's he going? Where's he taking him?
Slupex City.
Oh.
JBL up top.
Oh! Should have known that wasn't going to work out. Oh, big
elbow. Telegraph that one.
What does that even mean? Gonna run up a telegraph?
Yeah. Oh!
Telegram?
Right on the
I confused telegram. Telegram.
Telegram with telegram.
Oh, God. His foot's on the rope, ref.
But there are no DQs.
Is there not?
There should be rope breaks.
But why?
It's a submission
match. It's a submission match.
All right.
I guess if you hold the rope, you can't get DQ'd, right? Because it's not. I don't know how that works.
Oh.
Don't do it.
Fandango finally finding his own strength as a dancing machine.
How much strength do you have?
What does the scouter say about my power level?
Oh, he's gonna make him dance!
What the fuck?
He's dancing with him!
Why?
Oh! Forest Master! Oh, he's making out with him!
Oh, it was an Eskimo kiss! He rubbed noses!
Now he's just gonna make him submit! Bionic leg drop!
I think you have an agenda!
Me! He's a robot! Of course it's bionic! Oh, neckbreaker!
This is the beginning of the end!
Oh, he's up! Whoa!
Oh, wow!
God damn! Right to the outside, these two men go. Ah, get up, Jericho! I'm not wearing a bandana, you see? I have a suit on.
I'm glad bandanas are gross and people who wear them are gross.
Fuck you, chubbo. Back to the action. Solid.
Oh, did we take a break from the action?
Solid. Well, you did.
You're the one who brought it up.
Don't do it, Jericho.
There should be a ban on Danas.
They call me the bandanimal.
Oh, that's...
No one calls you that.
That's worse than Big Dog ever would be.
Oh!
The oil just fly off.
Oh!
Oh, no!
Jesus! He's stuck! Stretchy man!
It's gotta be hit.
What, rope break!
All that oil that went all over him. It's made him all slippery and slick.
Into the corner. He might dance with him now. Oh, maybe not. The fuck angle slam? Oh, never mind.
Do you enjoy Danimal yogurt?
It's alright, yeah.
Drinkable yogurt's fucking rad. Do they make those anymore?
JBL
never mind that shit.
Forcing him into the corner over and over and over again. Working over the back. Oh, the stretchy man's locked in. He doesn't have many places to go except Tap City.
Well, he is a dancer.
He's been... Will he tab? He's saying yes.
No, he's not.
Oh, okay.
I don't know what to make of this. What's the ref doing? He's oiling him up.
Is the referee involved? Is he the master?
Oh, my God.
Fandango with a reversal. Oh, steel forearm. Oh, God. Devastating. Oh, not again. Oh, planting him down on those.
Uh-oh.
Oh, God. Oh, God. Watch your arm, JBL. He's got spikes on his neck. Jesus! Oh,
spikes! The spikes got to him.
This has to be it. Stretchy man. Nearly center of the ring. Fandango has nowhere to go. He taps!
My God, what a burial.
What a squash.
I guess he really is a tap dancer. Oh, look at this.
Here's what we thought was perhaps the beginning of the end for JBL. Oh. What's wrong with his mouth? Jesus, JBL probably knocked it off is what happened. Fuck. JBL hanging himself up to dry.
Surely with these wins, JBL is positioning himself for a future world title shot.
Or at least intercontinentals.
Oh, let's not go crazy.
There it is. JBL hates illegal robots.
I don't think he's done.
Oh, no. Don't do it, JBL. Haven't you done enough? No! You son of a bitch!
Damn.
That piece of shit.
Duel is now emotionally involved in the SmackDown
What a jerk.
And that's the end of that feud.
I wouldn't put up with that on
Raw. That's how I'll book JBL to beat Fandango up for 5 weeks.
Look how angry JBL is.
I know.
Like, clearly he was set out to prove man's dominance over machine.
I guess so. Well, let's
and
move
he
on.
Really, ooh, feisty.
Let's move on to our next matchup here tonight. At Money in the Bank pay-per-view.
That was pretty feisty.
Oh boy.
Duel's first title match.
Duel, there's a lot of stuff riding on the line here. Fuck, who won that last one?
Who? Santino.
City?
Mm-hmm.
On the recap episode?
That doesn't matter. CM Punk wasn't even in a match.
Oh, that's right. Okay. Yeah, right. Cause I didn't, so Santino, who has the belt then? Santino?
Punk did the run-in, so I assume he has the belt like last time.
Nah,
that was only. Oh my god!
City that attacked was before the match, not after the match.
Yeah.
The belt is like bending inwards. It doesn't even fit all around him.
It's the king of the
There's
ring.
No belt extension.
Jesus Christ! He just had to glue it to his gear. The NXT Championship is on the line. The Ascension is on the line.
This man is getting a title shot at SummerSlam.
No matter what happens here, Santino will face the winner of Hulk Hogan and Batista tonight. Not tonight, but he will face him at SummerSlam. If CM Punk lets him get there, the curfew man, Punk. He doesn't look like he's been getting that great of a sleep lately, Jericho. It's probably because all these people keeping him up.
I mean, they did buy his house for him.
The biggest quieter in the business, Curfew Man Punk.
He likes it quiet.
He wants to be quiet so he can go to sleep. And he set out to make the WWE Universe go to sleep as well. Like Mussolini and Kennedy. Kennedy.
We're both dead and resting in peace. That's what he wants. He wants to rest in peace.
That's what he does want.
Rest peace in the world.
Falls count anywhere, Jericho. This match could end anywhere. It could end in the stands. It could end on the announce table. It could end on Justin Roberts. It could end in the ring.
It'll probably end in the ring.
It probably will. But they could do whatever they want.
Remember, though, CM Punk and Money in the Bank have a good history.
Do they? Why don't you tell me about it?
This one time, he won the title and ran away in his underwear.
Former two-time Money in the Bank holder, CM Punk. I need to show that gif on stream.
That's fucking amazing.
Look at a sign somebody's holding up in the crowd. And here we go. Punk and Santino. Building for weeks now. Who will leave the NXT champion? Who will leave the Ascension? And who will leave with the bragging rights? Drops his balls on his back, Jericho.
Oh, his balls have finally dropped, Johnny. Now I can finally stop wearing a bandana.
Oh, you think you're funny? Wind up punch to CM Punk. Vader probably wears bandanas.
He wears a giant fucking mask and a cowboy hat.
At the same time?
Yeah, in TNA.
That's cool.
It's the coolest. Oh, but so is CM Punk.
Coolest man.
He wants to go to sleep.
That's all he wants to do, Jericho. Can you really fault the man for just wanting to go to sleep? So much ruckus going on in the arenas that they sent him to, and he just wants to sleep.
He tried a ZZZ pack, but it didn't work.
He wants everybody else to go to sleep with him, though.
What a slut.
He wants to control the minds of all of these people and make them sleep.
Oh, God. Control mind Punk.
Like the Sandman.
He doesn't drink.
The real Sandman, not
like
the wrestling
Sandman.
Punk pulls him in. Big snap suplex there. Money in the bank. Uh-oh, where's Punk going?
He's going to sleep.
It's time to get extreme, Jericho!
Bedtime counts anywhere.
Oh, it's a ladder!
What's a ladder doing under the ring?
Punk, you're not in that match! Oh, fuck! Oh. Oh! Barrage of punches there. Barrett barrage.
I have that shirt. I forgot all about that.
Cover on the outside. Referee not in position.
I gotta slowly climb out of the ring.
Only a one count. The referee fucked over Santino there. Watch that ladder, guys. Jesus Christ.
Who'd he ever beat?
Cover. Referee, that's not lucky.
The referee doesn't care. He's gotta do his job.
Oh. Uh-oh, watch out. Oh, God!
Oh, right into the ref, and he's angry. Now, what made you make this match false count anywhere, Duel?
This is at a boiling point, and these guys need to settle it without the rules.
Why is it a boiler room brawl?
I don't think we have a boiler room.
Cover! Not even a two count, Jericho. Punk's got that ladder, though.
Well, a lot more to beat the king.
Oh, no. Watch out, Santino. Oh!
Really should have seen that one coming.
Oh, his feet.
His feet. His poor biggies. Don't run into it.
Oh, God, he caught it.
All right.
Watch out, Punk.
Oh! Tried to duck it.
Jesus. His feet. Oh, he laid it on.
No.
The ladder almost got a cover there. No. Northern Lights.
Oh, not on the ladder.
With the bridge. One, two, not even. The ref said it was four.
Boy, false count anywhere, but they really like this side of the ring.
They're going for all the covers here, Jericho.
I mean, there's no rope break. It's the perfect plan. Oof. Oh, Jesus.
Oh.
Oh, no. That's got to be it.
No, it's not! Not tonight, Jericho!
All hail King Santino.
Oh, they're going up the ramp!
Why does he continue to run?
Why does he stop
running?
Oh no! Anaconda Vice!
Oh!
There it is!
Oh my God, he's gonna hit him with a dose of NyQuil!
He said false count anywhere, not submissions!
Tapped!
He tapped! Punk wins! What the? Oh my God!
This is changing everything! Punk is the NXT champion!
He is also the Ascension!
And I think he has a legitimate claim to being a future World Heavyweight Championship contender.
I would say so.
At least the WWE title. That's really confusing.
He put him to sleep, Jericho. Literally.
CM Punk is the future.
He choked him out to sleep. Here it is. Oh, right on that exposed entranceway.
The other way.
These fans are in the way.
They're not even looking at the match.
Oh, no.
He's not done, Johnny.
He's not done. Don't do it, Punk. He's sleeping. Leave him alone.
Oh, wake up.
How'd he get back in the ring? Look how angry he is.
You ready for our World Heavyweight Championship match?
Oh, am I ever. Let's do it. Corey Graves and Brock Lesnar, the last match. The longest running feud in the history of the universe. The title is on the line. Here we go. Let's listen to Justin Roberts. All right.
Who the fuck is fucking with the production trust?
Champ's coming out first, and that really upsets me, but that's fine. Here comes Brock Lesnar. He must have said, I'm the champ. I'm number one. I want to be first.
Can't wait. Probably because Corey Graves got lost.
He's a mercenary, Jericho.
I am a mercenary.
No, I said he is.
Pyro.
He's always had Pyro there.
We have Pyro here, though.
No.
I remember when games had pay-per-view Pyros.
Brock Lesnar, the current reigning and defending World Heavyweight Champion, even though he only defended at pay-per-views. And that's one of these nights.
Yes, it is.
I'm putting this on slow.
That is a big fucking ladder on the top of that.
It is.
Why don't they use that to win the
match?
That'd
be fucking awesome. And here comes a piece of shit.
Mr. Arola shit. Why is he a piece of shit?
Cause!
Hattal's the one booking him.
That's true. You know what, Hattal? You're the piece of shit. The poor guy doesn't remember any of his matches. And you keep putting him in the same one because he doesn't realize he's facing Brock every fucking week. Why do you do it?
Wait and see.
Boy, the enthusiasm in that one.
But if Corey wins, will he still be irrelevant?
I guess not.
What if he becomes the world champion again?
Mr. Relevant he would become. Corey Graves, this is possibly the biggest match of his career, Jericho.
The other times he fought Brock Lesnar or not.
Well, those weren't, the belt wasn't on the line.
Twice it's been on the line.
I think he's only fought him once for the belt.
They've been fighting since.
Didn't they have one title match and Brock won it?
Oh, I forget what. Who did he fight at fucking Extreme Rules?
John Cena.
Oh yeah, of course. Where is John Cena?
John Cena retired after losing to Corey Graves.
No, he's looking for his tag belt.
Oh yeah, that's right.
Boy, I can't wait for the reboot of this universe so we can bring back great people like Cena.
Oh, nice graphic. Let's get to our introductions.
Finally got this. It's scheduled for Wonderful.
Corey Graves. Why is he so, like, gritting his teeth like he looks...
Lesnar! Brocko!
Brocko Lesnar! He is a mercenary!
Brocko Lesnar!
Beast East! Lesnar! Brocko! Give me
the
that
fucking
belt.
The streamers are flying and hitting Corey Graves in the head.
Oh, no! There it is. That's what it's all about, Jericho. The strap.
Some great men have held this title, such as Corey Graves.
Here we go.
It's all down this.
Every time. Every time it happens. Brock never sees it coming.
Well, why fix it? He thinks it's the same match every time.
He does, I guess so. They go over the same spots every week. Oh, that's a new one. Dragon Screw Leg. Oh, weep.
If you weep.
Stomping away at the Beast. Terra cool and not letting Brock Lesnar put any more advertisements on his gear. Oh. First a concussion. Now he's trying to get rid of his arm.
Well, you don't need both arms, do you?
I need both of them.
For what?
I would prefer to have both.
Well, why don't you have three arms? Brock Lesnar gets a third arm, he rips from Corey Graves, then it's even better.
Stomp to the back. Oh, Lesnar rolls away from it. You gonna climb with one leg? You gonna climb with one arm? You gonna climb with one arm?
Huh?
Oh, he's choking him.
Ow.
Blatant
whatever
choke.
Whatever it takes.
Brock trying to avoid everything Corey's doing, but Corey catches a big backdrop. Oh no. Oh! Trying to take out the eyes.
Don't do it, Corey!
Trying to take out the eyes. He needs those.
Well, does he need both of them?
He needs both of them.
For what purpose?
I would prefer to have both of them.
I like having both of them. Oh! These punches!
Would you take a punch from Brock Lesnar
no,
for $100?
For $100? No.
For no. $200?
No. Oh no. Oh fuck!
$1,000.
No.
That's how much it's gonna cost for your medical bills when you get your neck broken.
Well, speaking of neck breaking, there's a big drop, almost dropping him on the back of his neck.
I wonder how the fans feel about Corey Graves.
Corey Graves is an asshole, according to the fans. They just told me.
For what purpose?
Oh, for that! Oh!
Is that a boots to asses?
Let us not forget, they wanted Stardust. They didn't want Corey Graves.
Well, let's be fair, that Stardust CW sucked.
It was awful.
Corey Graves used to be Stardust. Stardust genius.
I don't know, maybe they've come around and started to like Corey Graves. Brock has been vicious on him. A man with a concussion shouldn't be treated this way, but a man with a concussion also shouldn't be booked this way. Oh, God.
Oh,
fuck.
Okay, he landed on his stomach.
Oh, he's up!
Oh, fighting spirit.
Clothesline! Clothesline!
Ducks the line! Power slam!
There it is! Vintage Corey Graves!
Now give him his irrelevancy.
Oh!
Oh, Jesus.
Taking out the knee. Oh no, Brock is up!
Like a caged gorilla, uncaged, an unchained King
Into
Kong.
The corner. Oh, big clothesline. Oh,
oh no!
No,
he's gonna do it too!
He's stealing it back! Don't duck the line!
Whoa!
Oh!
That was a new one.
Switches it up, cover! One, two. Whoa, way too close for comfort.
Stay down, Corey. That title just wants you out of the title picture.
Oh, God. Well, he might get his wish. He might get his
Suplex
wish, Jericho. Fuck.
City. Bitch.
Oh, it's Nick again!
Oh, no.
Rope break.
Oh, fighting spirit.
Kicking out at one or zero. Where's he sending him?
Oh, no.
Oh, no.
No. Oh, okay, good.
Oh.
That kind of fucked him up there.
It did.
Nobody knows how to fucking launch.
Oh, look, he's 13!
Oh my God, we're like, all that work on the leg!
Well, Brock tap!
Oh,
he tapped!
No.
Oh my God!
No.
Holy fuck!
Corey Graves!
How the fuck? Mr. Relevant!
Holy God shit. Damn it!
He's the champ again!
He earned his redemption!
Two times!
Oh,
Jerk.
That neck!
Two
How much longer can he take beatings like
Holy
this?
Holy shit!
There was nowhere those chicken legs could go!
He couldn't go anywhere! The most relevant man on SmackDown! Corey Graves!
Oh,
Atal's plan backfired! Oh my God! He did it!
Again!
Two times. Champ.
No, not one. Two.
He doesn't remember the first one!
Oh, that's right.
He's sucking dicks!
Jerking it off! Look at that!
Oh my
WWE! God.
Well, holy shit.
The reign continues.
Is the next match the Intercontinental title one?
I think it's the tag. I would go back and check. Right,
I gotta check.
Oh, he did good. Skipping leg day. You'll never do that again.
Oh my God.
Lesnar should have done his homework. He got caught early with those leg attacks.
Oh, feisty.
Tag team match. Should we change it to something else? Or should we just let
but
it play?
This, you get like it doesn't matter because these rivalries end. Right?
I mean, should I change the gimmick though?
We could just replace it with a tag title match.
Okay.
Like fuck these guys.
Yeah. Oh shit! I didn't mean to do that.
Oh no!
Oh God damn it! No! It was
God.
Meant to be.
It's meant to be.
It was meant to be, Jericho.
Oh.
Oh, no. I'm sorry.
Said it.
I'm going to go take a piss while the Undertaker comes.
Wait, we can quit if you want. I didn't mean to. Fuck. You want me to change it? Fuck it, I'll skip it all and we'll do it over.
My God.
I'm sorry. I want a tag title match for real, though.
Who would the Samoans fight?
The fucking filthy animals.
All right. I'll be right back because I really do have to pee.
All right, hurry up. Why were they coming out like that? What the fuck? Oh, wait, what? Oh, never mind. Okay. That match didn't happen. Fuck that. I'm not playing it out. Fuck all that. So sick of watching that. Suck my dick. Why do you guys want to watch that? Okay, that's still the same. No, it's still the same. We'll wait for Jericho to come back. NL hates its fans. Why? Everyone was saying not to fucking watch it. What are you talking about? If you change it, they'll take away a different match. Oh, really? Fuck. Why would it do that, though? The chat's chant for cunts. They already had a tag title. Well, they didn't have a tag title shot, did they? We were all saying not to skip. All right, here. We'll do a poll then.
I speak for everyone do when I say not, we not skipping. We wanted to watch that.
There. You decide. Oh, what a fucking shocker. So what was that, Salvador Zombie? Can I propose a good way of doing a tag title match? Sure, go on.
Not to do it.
Rapidoo.
The fans don't even want that match.
God, no. I also brought food.
People are saying that if we change this match, it might change other matches, though. You know what I mean? I mean, will it change these two, though? The rivalry matches?
It might change the Money in the Bank, but not the rivalries.
So just skip it.
You don't want to watch it? Okay. Alright, fuck it, we'll skip it. Decker and Luke Harper won, there you go.
Alright, now we gotta change this one to the Intercontinental title.
Okay.
It's the end of a rivalry.
How do I
change
it? How do I change it, though?
R1.
Okay. Who's
I
want to
see a table match.
Okay, you got it. What? Where's Cesaro? Fuck you, I'm not doing a submission match. Save. I just want to see if it changes other shit. Okay, it didn't. Solid. All right. Let's do it.
Ooh, it takes a really strong man to put somebody through a table.
It does. Who's getting wood tonight, Jericho?
Somebody.
Somebody getting the ass kicked. I know that much. The Intercontinental Champion Mark Henry has been holding on to that title for possibly far too long now. Will Cesaro be able to take it away from him? Jericho, stop eating.
I'm just so mesmerized by that 450 splash Undertaker just did in that last match.
That was pretty crazy. If you didn't catch that, you can watch that one on the WWE Network.
How is that Mark Henry's belt can reach around him, but Santino's can't?
This is a SmackDown matchup, ladies and gentlemen. Because we skipped that Raw tag match. Sorry, Duels.
I don't care.
Well, there you go. That's the only one opinion that matters to me. The GM.
And I'm pretty sure Mark Henry has been champion this entire time in this universe.
I think you're right. Cesaro is a guy. And what a guy he is.
He's the Prince of Swing.
Can't do that anymore.
My DualShock 4 is getting low.
Oh, DualShock? That's what this match needs, a DualShock. Pew pew. Will Cesaro be able to throw Mark Henry through a table?
Probably.
Or Mark Henry...
Jey Uso would be able to.
Hit the world's strongest slam right through that son of a bitch.
Hey, his mother was a good person.
And there's... the strap. You're right, Mark Henry's been the only Intercontinental Champion.
It's time for a change. All you gotta do is put your opponent through a table.
That belt right there. Why didn't they do the intros for this one? Is it the only main titles to do it?
Yeah.
Jericho, who do you think has the advantage in this one? They're both the world's strongest man, according to each other.
But who? According to Duel, that a tables match is the winner has to set the table.
Well, the table's already set.
Well then.
Oh, those are my rules. Hattal may have different rules.
Hattal, what are your rules for a tables match? He's thinking.
Oh, time.
Well, he thinks. Cesaro hits an STO. Once we figure out the rules of this match, we will let you know. Oh, lays him flat with that DDT. Cesaro. Oh, the disrespect, Jericho.
That's not going to put him through a table.
He could probably do that. Tucks him under his arm. Oh, went for an uppercut. No, scouted. Drops him down.
Now, you think Cesaro's yodeling will come into play here?
No, it won't. Splash!
That's not going to win you the match. Just put him through a table.
You got to weaken your opponent before you try to attempt that, Jericho.
Do you?
You should.
Oh,
speaking of tables.
Oh, no, he put his leg through the table.
Oh.
Like the Big Show.
Cesaro trying to take the table in the ring. There he does. Slides over it. Now, oh, he didn't set it up properly, though. If this was Raw, he would have won there. If he set it up properly, of course. But
and
that table's
Mark
set up.
Henry, oh!
It's set up in a very dangerous position.
We're forgetting about the tablecloth and silverware.
Oof.
Cesaro.
Big shot.
He might be in trouble. Oh,
boy. Oh,
boy. Don't lie.
Into the wrong corner.
That's what he does.
Oh, uppercut to
the... What's Mark Henry planning there?
Oh, no. Cesaro! Face first into that table. Fucking hell. Oh, no, not a splash again. God.
Oh, yeah, he zoomed over there, didn't he?
Cesaro's on fire! Oh, he's gonna throw him through it. Oh no, he's teasing you, Jericho.
Bastard.
Fuck. Will he splash him again? No. Pick him up by his.
How many splashes can one man take?
For real. What is happening here? Oh, I guess that wasn't the spot.
Mark Henry is never good at remembering spots.
Oh god. Henry's in a bad place here. Oh, reverse.
He gets
oh god.
Just in time. Oh.
Very close to putting him through that table. Mark Henry! It's like he's taunting Cesaro! He said, put me through that table, bitch! Try if you can, bitch!
I don't think he can. He's been splashed too many times.
Arm drag. Mark Henry doesn't know what to do, Jericho.
And nobody went over the match with him beforehand.
It's because he replaced a tag match. This was thrown together at the last minute. Or no, it didn't. I'm a liar. Oh! That doesn't count. That does not count.
That
does not count. He put himself through the table. You have to put your opponent through it. Oh, look at that. The carnage, the wreckage in the ring. Mark Henry. Oh. He's setting it up. There's a table in between these two men. Now they walk around to the sides. Uh-oh. Jericho.
Oh,
it's not looking good.
What's he gonna splash him?
Oh, no. What's he gonna do? Oh!
I hit him in the dick.
Oh!
Listen to the smack.
Where's he going?
Oh my god!
Oh my god! Mark Henry's heading up top!
For the Intercontinental title!
Oh god! Oh god! Oh! It's over!
That's what he does.
Jesus Christ!
Why are you the worst booker of all time, Tom?
Look at that! Oh, fuck! Here it is again at the same angle! Good God!
Cesaro has a claim to the title. He put Mark Henry through a table.
Well, that's for another day, Jericho. Mark Henry walks out of Money in the Bank with that strap, though. That white chocolate belt.
That chocolate dropped through the table.
Oh, he's The Rock now. He used to team with that guy. Mark Henry put everything on the line there, including his belt.
By any means necessary.
Could you stop eating, please?
I only got one more bite left.
Well, as you do that, we will move on to our WWE Championship match. Jericho, there's only one man that can walk out of Money in the Bank with the WWE Championship. And it's either Hulk Hogan or Batista. And one of these men will go on to face Santino at SummerSlam.
I am glad that they put these matches before Money in the Bank so neither champion could be screwed out of the title.
Until Raw, of course.
We should probably take a break.
All right, let's cut to a commercial real quick.
Real quick.
While Hulk Hogan's entrance happens.
Because who wants to see that?
Commercial on a pay-per-view. When was the last time you guys watched the pay-per-view? There's always commercials on WWE pay-per-views. Especially on the network.
By the network? Oh, you already did?
Alright. And we're back!
Is my mic working this time? You can suck my dick for one fall.
It's not during. The match hasn't started yet. They haven't made their entrances. And here comes the champ.
Out first.
Hey, it happens.
We dual booked this way. Now one of these men is going to pull out an overdrive.
Fuck you. Will Hulk Hogan be able to retain his title and go on to face the King at SummerSlam, or will the Filthy Animal come out on top? I know who my pick is. I know who my pick is, Jericho, but I'm not letting you know.
I know who your pick is, too, but I'm not going to let you know. I know you know.
That's fair.
Well, at Club 4 Life.
Too sweet.
Please.
The Liz Cliz.
With
said Macho
Blizz,
Man.
Blizz.
With Macho Man and Hogan.
Boy, that WWE title is really fucking ugly.
So are your glasses.
Look at that fucking bandana.
Look at that excellent, perfectly put together bandana.
Right, that's why he takes it off before he wrestles, because he knows he looks stupid in it.
Damn.
It'll fall off anyway, so what's the point?
That's true.
He wants to show off his glorious head of hair.
The champ is here.
But for how long? I can't wait for a long pant of the crowd.
I got long pants.
And long hair.
Batista, a man that came out of nowhere and stepped up to the champ.
I'm not sure why exactly he is getting this title shot.
Because he's the filthy animal.
I thought that had to do with Hollywood.
It probably did at one point, but now it's about the belt, Jericho.
When was it never about the belt?
When they never had a championship match. AKA the previous 4 weeks.
I see.
No, that was the last match.
Oh, okay.
He walks alone, Jericho, especially tonight.
How committed is he to the filthy animals? I never see him with them.
You don't need to get into their personal lives
is
like that.
Is he just using the warrior?
How could you say such a thing?
To get a world title shot.
What the fuck? How would a warrior get him a title shot?
He's got connections with Hogan.
Does he?
And Hogan's got connections with Duel.
Oh, shit.
That's true.
Remember all that Hulkamania Australian tour in 2009?
I do.
Yeah, who do you think co-promoted that?
Duel. Oh, wow. I didn't even think of that. No wonder why Hogan's had this belt for so long. Iron butt.
Mike Tyson.
Brass body.
Iron.
The hometown boy, Batista. Clickety click.
Indeed.
And let's go to our introductions. Justin Roberts, take it away.
This contest is set for one fall. To my right, in the blue corner, fighting out of Washington, D.C.
Batista!
This man is a Brazilian jiu-jitsu fighter. Batista!
Batista!
And fighting out of the green corner, he is the reigning, defending, WWE Champion of the World, the immortal, Hollywood, incredible, Hulk Hogan!
Incredible.
There it is, Jericho. That's what it's all about. Two men just going hard.
What more could you want? Duel really knows how to book them. Fucking a talent, Corey Graves.
Here we go.
Of course, Corey Graves is the world's champion.
He is. Oh! Starting off the match, trying to break Batista's neck. And punching at the side of his head, showing him the MMA was invented by Hulk Hogan. Did you know that?
Of course.
Oh, returning the favor.
As to whether we're going to see the debut of this mysterious NWO fighter.
Probably not.
We're going to have to wait a month for that.
STO.
Oh, STNWO.
Both men back on their feet. Oh, never mind. Hogan takes Batista down. The Deacon. Hulk Hogan.
Hollywood Batista.
Oh, stomping on the titty meat of Batista, and then drops him right on his face paint.
Is that face paint?
It is.
It looked like a mask.
Yeah, what do you know?
Masks.
I wish you would wear one.
Yeah, at least it's not a bandana.
Well, if you wore a bandana, I would like you to put it over your face. Oh, punching away at the ear of Batista. That's going to throw off his equilibrium.
Equilibrium of his cauliflowered ears will succeed him to the rocket ship fuel.
Of course.
And then it'll increase his inner warrior in
the title.
DDT.
Because when the elephant tries Hulk Hogan.
Uh-oh. The power of the Batista.
Does Batista have enough destrucity to defeat Hulk Hogan?
I don't know. You should ask him. You should check his destrucity levels.
Oh, my God. Let me get my meter out. Oh my God, it's off the chart!
Oh man, he's ready, brother!
I don't think he's ever been more ready for Hulk Hogan.
Who do you got in this one, Jericho? Lay it on me!
Well, after reading that meter, I can't go without anybody other than the animal Batista.
Wow, the filthy animal. Brass body!
I would like also to point out, I don't have a meter, I just went wee-wee-wee.
Oh, you're so silly.
It looked at my hand. in my hand was like,
did you actually, did you actually do that?
No.
Okay.
And now Bautista, fighting for the right to be champion.
And to party. Oh, God. Oh.
I'd say Santino would be watching this, but he's asleep somewhere.
That's true. He did get choked out by CM Punk, but this is a big deal here. He probably woke up for it. CM Punk definitely is sleeping, though. These men duking it out. Like, duke the dumpster drozy.
Reversal here. Russian leg sweep, brother.
Oh, no! Batista hates Russia!
Animal's back!
Oh, to get his ass pounded.
Right in his anal cavity. What's wrong with your hair, Hogan?
One! Disrespectful cover by Hogan. How could he think that would end a match against Batista?
Whoa, he reverses the...
Oh! Belly to belly!
Bailey to belly! I'm sure Batista will have his way with Bailey eventually. He gets through all of them. Like a boss.
Oh! Batista just going back to punching Hogan in the hairline.
I didn't realize Batista was a southpaw.
Oh.
Could this be Mirror World Batista?
What does that mean? Cover!
A one count. These one counts, he's not trying to win, he's just trying to psych out Batista.
He's trying to make him use his energy to kick out. Those 24-inch pythons are very hard to push up.
Oh, what does my scutter say about his power?
Your scutter?
Scunner? Gunner?
DDT!
Oh.
This is awesome.
This is mediocre, really. Their matches on Raw have been better than this.
Well, it's a slow build, Jericho. This is a pay-per-view.
It's a slow pace.
Action Bomba! Oh!
I didn't even realize the crowd could do the 1-2 finger thing.
Yes, of course.
How next generation? Oh,
big
neck breaker.
Spine buster. Stretchy man.
Stretchy man. We've already seen one title change hands by submission.
The referee's working on something over there. Oh, no, he's done. Whoa! The power!
Those tassels are going crazy.
Uh-oh. Can he lift them up? He did it!
Stalling vertical suplex, and Hogan's back is in pain. That
Cover.
Could be it.
He's got his fingers in his mouth.
Suck my fingers.
Brass fingers Batista, they call him.
Oh, that must taste like gross metal.
Oh. He's not a robot like Fandango.
At least Fandango wears gloves to, like, cover that shit up.
I don't think it helps.
Oh!
This is how they...
Oh, my goodness! This is how he won the match before!
Or how he lost it, actually!
Hogan,
like
Hogan.
This! Oh, again!
Oh,
you fool!
You stupid fuck, Batista. Why do you try that every time?
Batista, you're so dumb!
Literally, both men who lost the world title matches fell for the same shit.
Well, you know what that means, Jericho. SummerSlam. Santino
and Santino.
Hollywood versus Cobra.
Oh, God. But wait, we could have somebody cash in at
we
any
could.
Time.
Any time. And we'll find out who they'll be next. There it is. Dumb Batista. Failed the filthy animals and the Hollywood.
What an awful night for the filthy animals.
For real. That's Duel's moneymaker right there. You're gonna let him drop the belt already.
Won the belt of his own skill.
I noticed this show doesn't have a stage.
Couldn't afford it.
Ah.
Had to pay Hogan and Brock.
True.
On the same night.
I know there's something going on between you and Hogan, Duel. I'm going to figure out what.
Someone might be able to join us.
Hulk Hogan's small package, able to get him the victory once again. Invite him then.
I think... Oh, shit. Just in time for the last match.
After all this time. We may have an appearance from the commissioner, everybody.
Oh, great. He's going to make some big changes.
Just in time to see. who the big winner of the Money in the Bank contest will be. See if he answers.
7 hours.
We're calling on his cell phone. Is that Dario Culo? Hello, he's awake.
It's been over a month.
Dario, welcome.
Oh, good morning. Buenos dias.
Dario, you've missed a lot, my friend.
Oh, I've been told. I my phone is completely blown up.
I mean, the universe is going crazy over the happenings of not only Raw and SmackDown, but we're at Money in the Bank. You've slept for so long.
I wait. Wow. I mean, that's insane.
We did see you tweet earlier in the month about all the releases and stuff, so that's where you last left off, and now a lot of things have happened, Dario. I mean, Corey Graves is the world champion again.
Oh, shit.
JBL killed Fandango.
John BL has always been known for doing killing. So.
Santino has been getting destroyed by Curfew Man Punk, but he will now, after this, appointed by you, he will go on and face Hulk Hogan for the WWE Championship at SummerSlam. That is your boy, Santino, is it not?
Simon, yes.
Yes, I figured as much.
Who's Simon?
He hasn't come in yet. I have to sign his big dick.
Oh, yes. Well, Dario, you are just in time to watch with us to see who is the Money in the Bank holder.
Oh, shit. Well, I better take a nap before all this happens.
No. You can just wait.
Oh, okay.
It's happening right now, I swear.
Okay. I think I could stay awake for a little longer.
No, you just gotta stay up for a little longer. In this matchup, Dario, we have Triple H, we have Seth Rollins, Shawn Michaels, Dean Ambrose, Adrian Neville, and Rob Van Dam.
Michaels is gonna come out in jeans.
He has to. It's a prestigious occasion.
Dario, what are you eating over there, if you don't mind me asking?
Cold Fiesta potatoes from Taco Bell.
Man, only the best for you, huh, Dario?
It's true. I fell asleep after I got him in the car.
Well, all right.
Don't fall asleep and drive at the same time.
Coming out first,
Junkyard Dario.
Oh, Dean Ambrose.
A member of the SmackDown roster, representing SmackDown, Shawn Michaels.
I would have never guessed that was the show he was on. Has he ever competed?
I don't believe he has.
And he's got a shitty shirt with Sharpie on it.
Yeah, somebody just drew it on at the last minute. The print shop took forever. So
apparently in the Philippines, it is now 4:13 p.m.
Oh, that's way past right. That's way past CM Punk's curfew time.
Oh, wow. This is a beautiful display you guys got going on here. I love it.
He stole Fandango's pants.
What a dick.
An asshole.
Hey, I just found him lying around in the bed.
It's quite a crazy night tonight, you guys. I ended up making out with my ex.
Oh.
Oh, Dario Cueto.
I thought you were sleeping.
I woke up.
Oh, you mean in your dreams you were making out with your ex?
It sure as shit felt real.
So. He woke up with cold taco in his mouth.
When you're saying that, I'm eating a cold Doritos Locos taco.
Ay, chihuahua.
Jericho, I'm going to go out on a limb here, and I'm going to say that Seth Rollins is going to win the Money in the Bank.
I'm going with the new sensation, Adrian Neville.
I'm going with the old sensation, Triple H.
Oh, you're a Triple H guy.
Yeah, he owes me $5.
How about you, Duel?
Well, if he owes you, why would you book him to win?
What's that, Duel?
I'm not sure.
Oh, what about you, Hatile?
A difficult choice to make.
I'm guessing Duel and Hatile are just rooting for someone from their brand, of course.
I have to pick from my brand.
And here comes
the yellow champion!
The yellow champion representing SmackDown as well, Dean Ambrose.
Is the title on the line?
I don't know, it's not in the air, so maybe not.
Fair enough.
As you can see the poll there, Seth Rollins.
There's a beautiful yellow title.
Is ahead in the poll.
It's pretty evenly matched.
Dean Ambrose, yeah, it's a very close vote here. Seth Rollins in the lead, Dean Ambrose right behind him. Oh, he's
tied right now.
It's tied right now.
Oh, Dean's taking
the lead. Dean has just taken the lead after his appearance. Everyone remembered he had a belt.
That yellow title.
The yellow champion, Dean Ambrose. Who knows what we saw a little bit of what he could do when he faced Jack Swagger. Dario, please.
I'm
please.
Sorry.
Thank you.
I'm so sorry.
It's fine. I know this is a messy band, but you know.
I live here. I spent all the money on the events.
Of course.
I have to live in my fucking van.
And coming out next is another competitor.
Is that
it sure is,
NXT?
Johnny?
Oh, of course. It's Seth Rollins.
Seth Metal.
Mocking Dean Ambrose by coming out to the same music as him.
That is so... The mind games that he is playing with the Yellow Champion, Dean Ambrose.
Another man representing SmackDown, actually. SmackDown.
Oh, wow.
Is this a full SmackDown match?
I think it
is. It's interpromotional.
All we need is Heidenreich.
Oh, no. Yeah, Triple H is on Raw. The cunt, Seth Rollins.
What a cunt.
What a cunt.
I hope he does the overdrive.
But the man in the lead, the WWE Universe, the Dario Universe, is saying that Seth Rollins is going to win this one.
Oh, I wish I was part of the Dario Universe.
But if he fucking does the overdrive, that cunt is fired.
Oh, Dario,
oh,
you missed.
Oh, you're glad you missed that.
You missed a lot.
I fucking hate that move. It is so stupid.
You're telling
stupid
me. Old. I was also upset about this.
Are you going to fire Ricky Orton for doing like three of them?
You bet your ass.
Representing SmackDown, here comes Adrian Neville.
Wait.
Hatal, how did you get so many picks in this?
This is four people.
Hatal's not even here.
I'm here.
From White Castle upon Tide. The new sensation, the man that everybody forgot, Neville.
I don't think this is his debut.
He's got what?
16% of the vote here.
This is my pick to win because it's a debut.
He could shock the world tonight.
It's a pizza.
Two dicks touching.
Why?
That's what it is.
Me and my cousins touched wieners.
Okay. That's great.
That's what he's saying.
Up next.
Okay, the entrance is over. So
second to last. Oh, representing Monday Night Raw, the King of Kings.
Oh boy.
He's Dario's pick
knees,
to win.
On your knees, dog. Big dog.
Let us remember that Dario picked Santino to win the King of the Ring. Now he's picking Triple H to win Money in the Bank. Who knows if that will come to fruition?
Hey, Dario. Am I the big dog, officially?
It's true. I put a little barrel of whiskey around your neck.
That is
our medallion here in the Dario Universe.
Oh, I see.
Oh, I got one of seven medallions.
One of seven? Who is the other? Who is the other? Six.
We'll find out as time goes on.
Oh, I see.
Oh, shit. Am I allowed to drink this?
Yeah, you could drink it. It's cool.
Triple H with 15.4% of the vote. Seth Rollins in the lead.
I'm going to have to drink it to get through this bit. Wait a minute! What's that in Triple H's hand?
What is that?
Oh, he just threw the medallion to the crowd.
Fan now has a medallion.
Well, I guess that guy's the chosen one.
Triple H with 30 votes here. Seth Rollins with 42. Shawn Michaels with 19.
Michaels.
Dean Ambrose with 39. Adrian Neville with 31. And Rob Van Dam with 35. It's very close here. Shawn Michaels not in the running.
That means he's going to win.
Well, you never know.
It's probably because he's wearing that shitty jeans.
Probably. He's a thief. Dario, I'm also very sorry that you had to endure watching all the twins. I know the reason why you fired him is because you hate your twin brother. We won't really talk about him, but I just wanted to send my condolences.
Piece of shit.
Yeah.
Yo de puta.
I know
what about your other brother?
I know he stole all of your ideas. We don't talk about that brother, Jericho. And here comes the final participant in the Money in the Bank matchup. Representing Raw, it's Rob Van Dam.
But where's Ric Flair? Where's Colonel Mustafa?
He doesn't need them. He's all on his own tonight. He walks alone.
Well, he's dead, so. I'm kidding. I'm kidding.
What's that?
Hasn't RVD been on more episodes of SmackDown than Raw?
Oh, hi, Tyle.
I believe that is true, yes. But you can't. You already have four people claimed. You don't need any more.
Duel, why would you allow Hatal to have a 4-on-2 advantage over you?
Well, I think that Duel believes in his talent so much that he picked his two secret weapons.
He picked one guy who's more SmackDown than Raw in Triple H, who, where the fuck has he been?
I don't know. He's been on Saturday Night's Main Event and the
Maybe
house show loop.
Maybe him and Kulo are in cahoots and they Maybe. Both know Triple H is going to win.
Say what?
RVD, the best buns in the business. No?
He's not going to be happy with Shawn Michaels' shirt, which is almost 420.
I just got that.
Oh, Dario is very amused.
Thank you. Big dog never disappoints.
Should I call you Mr. Kulo or should I call you Dario?
You could call me Susan if it makes you happy.
That doesn't make me happy. All right.
That's a girl's name.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's time. Here we go.
That wacky Dean Ambrose stole Shawn Michaels' shirt.
Dean Ambrose ripped the shirt off of Shawn Michaels and put it on himself.
Inside out, so he doesn't have that stupid shirt.
Neville and Shawn Michaels both going for ladders. Oh, God! Oh, oh God!
This is not. This is crazy.
Jesus!
This is madness!
Already swinging a ladder like a madman. He's got it set up already, but Seth stops him.
Remember, what's up for grabs in this match? A briefcase, which gets you a title shot.
Of course.
At any time you want.
It's true. I have been trying to reach that briefcase forever, but I am scared of heights. So if they can get it down, whoever can get it down and bring it back to me gets a unique opportunity.
Oh.
Well,
you know a lot about unique opportunities. You gave Santino his unique opportunity, and now he's facing Hulk Hogan at SummerSlam.
Simon, yes.
Triple H!
Triple H already reaching for it. Oh, he's levitating! What the fuck? He's got the briefcase! He's holding on to it! Oh, God!
He is a whole
what
lot of
fuck?
Magic.
What the fuck? What just happened?
What happened?
The game crashed!
I can't see anything!
The game crashed!
Well, that's... Well, fans, we are fucked.
Triple... Dario, what are you doing here, man?
What's going on with Triple H?
Dario, what is this?
I thought I set up direct automatic bill pay.
Dario!
In the feed.
Are you trying to rig this?
What? No.
Is this the NWO?
It could be the new West Africa.
You son of a bitch, Dario. I don't know what you're planning here. I liked you, but you seem a little funny lately, Dario. I gotta tell you.
Well, you killed my parents.
I've been working on the routine. It is fun, so.
You son of a bitch.
I'm gonna find you and your brother.
Are you still in my... Brother. Are you still viewing this, Jericho?
Yes.
Okay.
Oh, it was on PS. I thought it was on PC.
No.
So were you guys playing, or were you just watching?
I think we should have a new...
We're just watching.
Bank.
No.
You're going to allow this madness to continue.
We gotta! We aren't in charge, Jericho. We don't book things. We
Not
just say
yet.
The words. I hope that all saved. It did,
so
thank
too.
God. Okay, it did.
Okay, good. I was going to say, it was going to be a real
all
bitch
right.
to fucking
Here we go.
Redo that.
Let's get right back into it. We had some technical difficulties there. We last saw Triple H falling off a ladder, and he landed on a cable, and it knocked out the feed.
That sounds like something that happened with the NWO in our last fucking universe. Like day three Tokyo.
Thank
bullshit.
Fuck we didn't turn autosave off. God damn it.
Yeah, always keep that shit on.
Seth Rollins still in the running, in the lead, in the pole.
Poor Shawn Michaels. Triple H is not happy. Look at that.
He's not.
He's like, what the fuck?
Are you fucking serious right now, bro?
And here we go. Back into it. We will refund you your $9.99 because of that incident.
I'm calling bullshit. We gotta retape the segment.
Just like SmackDown.
Oh, Triple H is not wasting time. Or, yes, he is.
So he can climb the steps to get the briefcase.
This is so big.
He is wasting a lot of time, yes.
Okay.
What is he doing?
He's so upset.
This fucking bullshit.
The ladder is moving on its own.
big suplex by Dean Ambrose.
Here's my pick, Neville.
Neville's got the ladder.
Oh no! Shawn Michaels just came back from back surgery.
Triple H, the only. Oh my God!
Well, the Triple H might just win this.
Dean Ambrose has a ladder set up though. He's not sure what to do with it. Oh,
what
the fuck? Neville's getting a second ladder now. Oh no, he's not. Excuse me. Oh no, God! Eye poke by Ambrose to stop him.
What a crazy goy.
Oh. Oh my God, your pick just got shattered with a ladder.
And I did it.
Ambrose is climbing up.
Oh, he's so crazy, he's gonna steal the briefcase.
He's got the briefcase in hand. Nobody's stopping him.
Sam's an idiot.
Oh God, oh God, oh. Shot to the gut of Seth Rollins. As Triple H hits Shawn Michaels on the backdrop, a lifelong friend, Jericho. He doesn't care, he just wants the briefcase.
Oh, I would want the briefcase as well. Think RVD's, of the opportunity. Think
RVD's,
of the unique opportunity.
What the fuck? That's true.
We don't know what's inside now, apparently. Apparently just a unique opportunity.
I'm pretty sure we know what's inside.
There better not be any spiders in that briefcase.
Oh, I hope not.
There better not be any bandanas in that briefcase.
Seth Rollins and Dean Ambrose continuing their battle outside as the other four men fight it out on the inside. Triple H setting up a ladder.
Triple H is a cerebral assassin. He knows how to win. He's smart.
Of course.
Not as smart as Mark Henry was earlier. He's the world's smartest
Mark Henry
man.
He is the world's smartest man. Dario, we know you're a man of great intelligence as well, but I don't think you're as intelligent as Mark Henry. Oh, God.
That's what I do, I saw math.
Oh, he slapped him in the face, Jericho. Uh-oh, Shawn Michaels is up there alone. Wait, what's
what
he doing?
Idiot.
What is he doing? Oh my God!
What a fool, he could have won.
He is not the world's smartest man.
What is Neville? This is not a tag match.
He's trying to get tagged in. Oh Christ!
Oh no.
Triple H over and over again, setting up this ladder.
Shawn Michaels could have won.
Seth Rollins is keeping people at bay on the outside. Oh shit.
Yeah, Neville.
Seth Rollins, everyone picked to win.
Why?
I don't know. He's keeping RVD on the outside, though. What does he know? Oh! Oh God! Reverse run in the Triple H! Two ladders in the ring. Ambrose.
Oh, dueling ladders!
Dueling ladders!
Oh no!
Uh oh, Ambrose climbing up his Triple
Ambrose,
H.
That wacky man!
It's Neville with a face buster.
Waiting for Triple H to break it!
We'll never break orbit in this match.
Break orbit!
Break Norbit.
I know I do.
Already sent back into the ring by Rollins. Oh, that ladder is on his body!
Oh.
Where's Neville going?
Neville, stop doing spots. Stop doing cupcakes.
He heard you from the table.
Good.
Can't see!
What's going on?
Oh, God. Ambrose with an Irish whip. Pedigree to Seth Rollins!
Oh, he used his own finisher against him. The arrogance of Triple H.
Why didn't Dean Ambrose or Shawn Michaels dress up for the occasion?
Shawn Michaels is dressed to fight.
Is he?
Where's Triple H going?
Shawn Michaels is going up, that's what I can tell you.
Oh, no.
Indeed. This is looking pretty good.
What
here
is with
for,
these steps and Triple H?
Neville, go!
Oh, God.
No, Neville, no!
Oh!
Neville saying, fight me.
Oh my God, Triple H just busted Seth Rollins wide open. He made him bust it wide open, Dario.
We got a situation here. They're waiting for somebody to...
They're staring at each other. They don't want to hurt each other. Ambrose wants to hurt them both. Oh God! Neville!
That is disgusting.
Arvid's knees!
They're no longer the bee's knees.
It's true. His lower arms are really hurting right now after taking that severe shot.
Spine buster! To Seth Rollins, Triple H going after the fan favorite. The cunt.
I haven't seen Seth do a goddamn thing in this match.
He was beating up people on the outside the whole time. The man that everyone. Oh!
Sway chin music!
The man everyone calls a cunt. What the fuck? Shawn Michaels just hit himself with a ladder. Curb stomp!
Oh, don't look!
Oh.
Don't do it, bro.
This match is insane. It's on pay-per-view. Oh! You can't ban anything on pay-per-view.
It's true.
And now, Neville, what is Triple H doing?
He's crazy. Dario must have given him some advice. Uh-oh. He might hit Seth Rollins with another pedigree, Jericho.
In order to gain a unique opportunity.
Ambrose.
Become unique.
Ambrose, dirty deeds. God.
Those dirty jeans.
Shawn Michaels is now busting open. This is a sadistic match.
Dirty beans?
Dario, you sure know how to pick them. I don't know why you gave SmackDown 4 people and Raw only 2. Or is it the other way around? No, that was right.
Because it's like fine strawberries. You pick the right ones, and the crowds will flock.
Seth Rollins is all by himself! He can't reach it, though! He's a vanilla midget!
He's so stupid!
Oh, no!
Triple H just wants to beat on his old friend. Ambrose! What are you doing, Neville?
He's climbing! Neville! Where's Neville? 450! Oh, Triple H, the smartest man in this match, rolled Shawn Michaels into the ring to break up the ladder attempt. Ladder attempt. Oh!
I'll allow it. That's the tangible way to say it. Ladder
Thank
attempt.
Thank you, Dario. RVD with the ladder again. Oh, hits Ambrose with it as he sets it up. Van Damme is climbing. Not for long. What the fuck? Neville!
Oh,
Neville
God.
And Shawn Michaels!
Break Corbett!
Everyone's about to break. Oh no!
Fuck that shit, mate.
What is Neville doing? He's going for that second ladder. He's dancing on it. Oh! Seth Rollins got it because Neville's an idiot. Oh no, pedigree to Shawn Michaels! Triple H is making sure to take out everybody he can.
He's so cerebral.
Irish whip by Shawn Michaels into the corner goes Triple H. Ambrose with a total anarchy. Oh, both ladders out of the ring!
Just attacks Seth Rollins.
Four men on the outside. RVD looking to pin Shawn Michaels. Slowly moving back into the ring. The greatest move ever!
Greatest move in wrestling.
Guillotine leg drop.
Here it comes, baby. Oh, yeah.
What the fuck is happening? This is fucking dangerous.
Just like flip mode squad.
Oh, for
so
a chance to become the world or WWE champion.
Well, I said unique opportunity. I never said straight up they're going to get a belt.
Uh-oh. Neville's climbing up.
Go, Neville! Go!
Neville's going up! No!
He's so stupid.
I just had to re-verify. I never said anything about giving a championship. Stop putting words in my cooler.
I put a lot more than that if you don't shut up.
Cool.
Oh, shit. Shawn Michaels can't see! Oh, God!
He thought he had it.
Oh, God. Split leg on the ladder, kinda.
His knees hit the ladder.
RVD doesn't want knees anymore. That ladder is attacking the crowd. Curb stop to Triple H!
But I didn't look. It's not allowed.
RVD's climbing up. Ambrose. Suplex to Rollins. RVD's got the briefcase!
Damn! Go!
He's gone! RVD!
It's for money in the bank!
Van Damme takes it! Duel was right! He only needed two!
And one side is RVD on! He could cash it on either show's tier.
There it is!
Is he Raw or SmackDown? That's what we don't know!
We will find out eventually, but RVD! He did it for Sheik! He did it for Flair!
He did it!
For The Rock!
He did it for Duel!
He did it for The Rock, bro.
Those strong arms were able to yank down the briefcase!
Alright, let's interview Rob Van Dam. What do you have to say about this win, Rob?
Well, first off, I just want to thank my lovely wife, Sonya, and I couldn't have done any of this, especially pulling down the briefcase for the victory, without proper arm strength.
Of course.
How euphoric he looks right now.
He's so happy. What a show. Mr. Money in the Bank, Rob Van Dam.
I just want to give a quick shout out to my gym, RMVD's, corner of 420 Blunt Street. So ask for Sonya, you get a free towel.
Wow, what a deal.
What a unique opportunity.
Hey, I know I love it.
There is the winner. Oh, and then everybody else too. Rob Van Dam, your money in the bank.
Again.
That's right, the briefcase was red. It was meant for a raw person the whole time, Jericho.
Oh, I smell a conspiracy.
Son of a bitch, Dario.
It's time
what?
To
what did I do?
Every rivalry must die now.
Oh, man, there's one money in the bank match. He can cash in and challenge the current champion whenever he wants.
Hey, can I help it if red is such an alluring color? It doesn't mean that there's a conspiracy or anything. I don't know what you're talking about. As my good cousin would say, that's not considerate of you to accuse me. So.
Here are your champions before we move on into a new era of Universe Mode. And what will that be? Find out next time!
Same Kulo channel. Same Kulo channel.
Same Kulo.
Dario, do you have a message for the fans before we wrap this up?
Be sure to wipe front to back. And always, always, always buckle up when you go memes.
I love memes.
I love memes. See you later, guys.
Love you.